We are talking about justice and rape. Let's talk about love before we move down to justice, because I think love and justice move together. If you could speak every language on earth, like you know both languages of heaven and earth, but you don't love, what good will you be of people? What good will you be to people? And if you could see the mysteries in life, both now and in the future, and you don't love others, you will be of no good to anybody. If you give out everything you have to the needy, you can even boast about it. But if you don't love, what good would that be of? Love is never proud of injustice. Love is never happy of injustice. Then why the injustice? Okay, now let's move down to the injustice. A woman is your mother. I'm sure you have a sister. Sure you will end your life with a woman. Then why can't you control the sexual urge of yours? Can't your sex urge be controlled? It's a 5-minute pleasure to you. But talking about lifetime pains, talking about lifetime pressure to her, we need to end rape. Like, we need to shun rape. Let's even bring out sense. When you held her, when she screamed, I'm sure she begged you. She was like, please, I will do anything, but please, don't do this. Weren't you conscious? Like, didn't you sympathize on how her scary look at you was? I'm sure she shed tears. And you won't be happy to see your sister shedding tears and pleading for something. Things of no utility with pleasure. But do you think all these devilish acts can let us prosper? God, literate we are, but illiterate we act. Some things we do. I even wonder if some of us have education or if we are educated. Let's come down to nature. Naturally, we should be our brother's keeper. And even biblically, I'm sure even the Islam and the traditional leaders encourage us being our brother's keepers. But God, how can I be my brother's keeper when I am of harm to him? How can I be my sister's keeper when I harm her? The traditional religious leaders, both Islamic and Christianity, I mean our religious leaders in general, never encourage injustice and never encourage wickedness. But God, 90% of men nowadays can't do without wickedness. Yes, I said wickedness. Because you can't rape me and you call that justice. You can't rape me and you call that sympathy or security. As a human, I should be of security to anyone connected to me, because we are united already. For how long will we keep practicing devilish acts? For how long will we keep practicing things of no use? Like, seriously, our government need to shun this. I mean, let's end this now. As a mother, I won't be happy to hear my child misbehaving in such way. And no father will be proud of such acts either. I'm sure all your siblings wouldn't support such acts. But why then? Why the heartbreak? We need to end this now. This has to stop now. I mean, it's high time we end this now. It's high time we know that women deserve value, great value. When I talk about value, I mean they need respect, huge amount of respect from the society. Because without them, I mean without women, there will be no you.